You better be there when I shake. Watch me rocking if I can't stop. If I should fall, just go ahead. Go and catch me, baby.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is a luxury unboxing video. I have been doing a little bit of shopping for the new season and I've gotten some really, really great items. So I'm going to be unboxing them and sharing them with you in today's video. It's a mix of items. I have a few clothing pieces in here, but it's mainly accessories. I have a pair of shoes, some SLGs, bags, just a mix of everything. So I hope you guys enjoy this and let's get started. This video does continue on my collaboration with Farfetch, and I know so many of you already shop with and love Farfetch, but on the off chance that you're not familiar with them, then they are basically an amazing destination for all things luxury. When you shop with Farfetch, you're actually shopping from boutiques all around the world. And because of that, the stock selection is incredibly vast, whether you're looking for a new pair of Jimmy Choo shoes or perhaps some new summer sandals, a new bag, like you'll just get pages and pages of results, and it's always such an amazing shopping experience. So much of what I'm featuring here today is available from Farfetch, so I will include links to everything in the description section if you did want to check anything out. They were also nice enough to give me a discount code as well. This is for new customers and there are some T's and C's, so I will pop all the details in the description section. I will also pop the code on screen as well. Everything that I'm featuring here today does work with the discount code, so again, I'll pop all details and links in the description section if you did want to check that out. So first up is a pair of shoes, and I am crazy excited about these. They are from Gianvito Rossi, which is by far my favorite shoe brand. If you followed me for a while, you will know that my love for Gianvito Rossi really runs deep. Like, I absolutely love them, and I think they are by far the most comfortable designer heels out there. And I saw these, and many people may say that they're not that exciting, but for me, these are like just so exciting. So they are some neutral heels, but I'm gonna show you exactly what they are. So you do get the dust bag with it. And then inside are these beautiful pumps. So these are the matte leather pointy toe heels, and these are the 85s, which are by far my favorite heel height. They do a lower one, a slightly higher one as well, but for me, the 85s are perfect because they are high enough to give you a proper boost, but they're also super comfortable as well. And this is the first time I've actually got a pair of heels from them, which are full leather as opposed to suede. All my other pumps from them are suede, which I do find to be very versatile, very comfortable as well, and actually quite low maintenance. But I do think it's nice to mix it up, and suede doesn't go with absolutely everything, especially if it's a particularly dressy outfit. So I thought these would be perfect to kind of fill that hole. And they are gorgeous. As I said, I never actually tried the plain leather. I'd only ever tried suede, which in general I do find to be a little bit more comfortable. So I was wondering how comfy these would be. But upon first trying them on, I do find them to be very comfy. Hopefully just as comfortable as the suede ones. And I think they are absolutely stunning. And the color is a beautiful neutral as well. Like, I'd say it's a nude, but with like a hint of pink. So there's definitely some blush tone. So I do think it's gonna go with my skin tone pretty well. The leather is incredibly soft. It is very lovely. And you just tell the quality is really there. As I said, I absolutely love this heel height. I find it the perfect height for me. And it's just such an elegant shape, you know, a really nice pointed toe. There is a little bit of toe cleavage, but not too much. I often find on Louboutins, like, there is so much toe cleavage that it just doesn't feel very stable on your foot, and they really sacrifice comfort for the look. Whereas this, I think, strikes exactly the right balance. And I'm just obsessed with these. Like, I'm so excited about them. They did have these in quite a few different colors as well. So if you're after a particular color, I would definitely recommend checking these out, because they might well have them, and they just seem to have so many different types. And I am just obsessed with this shoe. The 10% off does work with these as well, and it's often really difficult to find Gianvito Rossi heels at a discount because they are so popular. You know, they are a classic item that they bring back year after year. So to get them at a discount is certainly better than paying full price. And as I said, I just absolutely love these, so would definitely recommend. Hopefully the plain leather ones will work out just as well as my suede ones. But yeah, I am super excited about this addition to my shoe wardrobe. Next up is a Jimmy me Choo box, and this isn't actually a pair of shoes but a bag, and I don't have too much experience with Jimmy Choo bags. I've had one clutch from them before, but I've never really looked at their other pieces too much, but I saw this and I thought it'd be absolutely perfect for hopefully all the nice weather we're going to have. We keep on being promised a heat wave and it really hasn't happened yet, but hopefully it will soon. If not, I do have a few holidays booked, so hopefully this will get a lot of use. So it is very, very well packed. So you have all the beautiful tissue paper. It's just so padded and lovely. You have like the Jimmy Choo print, and there's just something about like crisp tissue paper that I absolutely love. And then you have the invoice details here. And then inside is a little dust bag. How gorgeous is that? So it's a raffia and leather trim clutch. So this one has Jimmy Choo over the front, and it just says Jimmy Choo London. It is plain on the back except for a little stamp right there in gold. And then on the base, it is completely plain. And then you have that really beautiful white leather trim all over. It is a clutch style and it just opens up with a magnetic closure. There's no actual buttons. So this strip is all actually a magnet, but it's a hidden one, so it's just very, very seamless and elegant looking, just very kind of subtle in the details. There's a little bit more tissue paper inside. And then inside is a fabric lining, so it's a very, very light bag indeed, and you do have one pocket right there at the back. I thought this was absolutely beautiful. I love my raffia bags, and even though it is a seasonal style, it's something which, you know, every single year these come back. So it's both seasonal and also classic as well, which I think is just kind of the perfect combination if you are looking for a summer appropriate bag. And I thought this was beautiful. I hope I'm gonna get a lot of use out of this. I did get my Fendi one a couple of years ago, and actually I've used that one a ton, and it's such a mainstay for me in the warmer months. So I was hoping this one might lighten the load on my Fendi clutch. And I do think it has that similar kind of vibe in that, you know, it's raffia, you do have that logo print on there. I actually feel like this one's a little bit more subtle because it is in white. You can fit in a little bit more than the Fendi clutch as well because you have that width or the depth right there. So actually it can fit in a decent amount. And I just think this is gorgeous, like really, really excited. The quality, it does look to be really lovely as well. Like looking at the detailing, the stitching looks to be very, very nice and neat. The leather seems to be really beautiful quality. And I just think it's gorgeous, like really, really beautiful. As soon as I saw it, I was really excited. And now I have it in person, it's just completely lived up to expectations. Just absolutely beautiful. And hopefully I will be getting a lot of use out of this summer. Next up is an off-the-shoulder top. And this is very similar to an ASOS bodysuit that I had a few years ago. In fact, I still own it. But I wore that thing so much that it literally has a hole in it. Like, I definitely got my money's worth because I think it was only like £12 to begin with. But I've been on the lookout for something to replace it, which is perhaps a little bit more sturdy. Not that it did badly because I feel like I wore that thing like 200 times. But I wanted something just a little bit thicker. And I saw this and I thought it was perfect. It's not a bodysuit, but it does have the kind of fabric which I think is going to kind of be tucked in very easily, which was my big thing with the bodysuit. Like, I love the fact that it does give you that seamless look. But this one I actually don't think is going to create lumps or bumps either. And it is just a very simple kind of black off-the-shoulder style that I find these so useful. I wear a ton of skirts and I think it's just such an easy outfit to throw on. You know, obviously also team it with denim as well and I think it looks great. But for me, I have a ton of skirts. I'm always looking for a cute top. It's nice to mix it up from just a general camisole. And I think these are just so elegant, so easy to throw on. And I just love them, and I know how useful they are in my wardrobe because, as I said, I wore my ASOS one to death. So hopefully this will be just as useful. Very, very classic design and just a really great wardrobe staple that hopefully I will get just as much use out of. Next up is a bag from Anya Hindmarch, and I have been on a big Anya Hindmarch kick recently. I genuinely feel like she is one of the most underrated luxury designers. I have loved her pieces for years, and her designs just never get old for me. And I haven't really gone too far into like her proper leather bag lines. Mostly what I go for are her SLGs, also her kind of more inexpensive tote bags, which I absolutely love. I saw this though and thought it was stunning and so perfect for hopefully some warm weather. If you can't tell, I'm so ready for some sun. But I just thought this was beautiful. So it's a kind of, it is a clutch style, but it's also with a crossbody strap as well. So perfect for for summer holidays or just generally warm summer days. And it is a leather one, but it's like a leather weave kind of braided look to it, if that makes sense. I will do close up so you can see. It does have the Anya Hindmarch ribbon logo embedded in the design, which I think is so clever. So it's not kind of stuck on, it's really like in the braid design. On the back, it is totally plain, same as on the bottom and the sides. And then it just opens up with a magnetic closure, and you do have the adjustable strap right there. So as I said, you can wear it just on the shoulder, you can wear it crossbody. It is fairly versatile in that way. And I do have the boutique label there, as well as a care card as well. And then you also get, in addition to the crossbody strap, you also get a shorter strap if you wanted to wear it as a wristlet as well. So it is a truly kind of multifunctional bag. There are so many ways to wear it. You can do it as a clutch, a wristlet, crossbody, on the shoulder, like just so many different ways, which I always love because I just feel like you get so much more bang for your buck. And then on the inside, it's completely plain, so it's not lined or anything like that, but you do have that kind of like almost card holder pocket detail right there on the back. So there are two slots for your cards and then one slightly deeper pocket, and you have the beautiful Anya Hindmarch stamping with her ribbon logo as well. Just beautifully made, like the attention to detail is gorgeous, as it is with all of her items. Really lovely. You have little bits of gold hardware here and there as well. And I just thought this was so charming and lovely. I'm planning on taking this to Greece with me, as I am the Jimmy Choo clutch as well. We are going in, gosh, I think 4 weeks, which is slightly terrifying because I feel like I need to start packing now. We just went to a wedding on the weekend and I genuinely feel like we brought half our house with us, and I'm just dreading how much stuff we're gonna need to pack for Greece. So it's gonna be interesting, but I am really looking forward to just some really nice weather and hopefully getting to use all my beautiful new accessories. Next up is this beautiful dress, and this is from a brand called Madge, who I have mentioned before. I've been shopping with them for, gosh, it's got to be like over 10 years now. And the items that I bought 10 years ago, I still have my wardrobe today. So they are beautifully made. They are a French brand, and I just adore so many of their pieces. And I saw this dress and I just thought it was so pretty. So it is kind of a sundress, but because the fabric is quite slinky, I do feel like it can be really dressed up as well. So it does have that beautiful soft feeling, and it kind of almost has like a bit of a Grecian look to it because of the ruching. And you have this slight almost braided detail around the bust as well. You have very, very thin spaghetti straps, which you can adjust for a really nice fit. And then you have this great cutout detail right on the sides as well, which I absolutely love. And then it just kind of flares out. It is a bit of a longer one, so I think this will look equally beautiful with flat sandals as it will with heels. Just a really nice one which you can kind of dress up really easily. And you pop it with some beautiful jewelry. And I just think it's so elegant. You know, it is black, which is one of my favorite colors. But I do think because it's black, it can actually see through to so many different occasions. And I just absolutely love this. Like, fits really, really nicely. So easy to throw on. Again, easy to dress up or down, and just a really, really beautiful, dreamy dress. And now for a cardigan from Madge. If you couldn't tell, I was looking at their new arrival section and I saw this and I thought it was absolutely beautiful. I do think I might try the next size up because it did fit a little bit snug. So I am gonna try and see if the next size fits a little better. But I love this for its kind of Chanel-esque vibes. It is a lighter colored one though, so I'd say it's almost like, I don't want to say orange, I guess more like a peach color. It's really, really pretty though. It's still a pastel color. And you have these really pretty little sparkle details all the way through. I thought this was just so charming and lovely. The button details are beautiful on it as well. So they're these silver buttons with this braided detail as well, like really, really elegant. And it just feels like a really beautifully made cardigan. I wouldn't say it's like a really lightweight one just to throw on. It almost is a cross between a cardigan and a blazer. There's definitely some weight to the knit material, but it just feels like it's so well made. You have these great pockets on the front as well. And as I said, it's just very kind of Chanel-esque, very classically French. And I just thought this was absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, very, very excited for this. As I said, I have ordered the next size up, so I'm gonna see which one fits better, but yeah, super, super excited about this. I just think it's gorgeous. Next up is a little mulberry scarf that I got, and I am really getting more into my kind of scarves and accessories in general that can dress up things I already own. And I saw this and I just thought the colorway was beautiful, but I also thought it would go really well with some bags that I already have in my collection. I'm a big Mulberry fan, and two of my favorites still are the Mulberry Mini Alexa and also the Mulberry redesign, so like the top handle Lily. I thought this would go beautifully with both of them, especially because I got both in the kind of chalk color. It's like a very, very pale, like off-white. I just thought this would be absolutely beautiful to dress them up and just give them like a slightly different look. I always think it's so fun to do that, you know, just one small purchase, one small addition can really transform the look of something. And I really learned that with my mini Fendi peekaboo. The sales associate that helped me was nice enough to wrap a little twilly around the handle, and I just love the look. So I've been very, very into it. I've been using that bag a little bit recently, and I just think it's so cute and charming. The scarf really does help to just make it feel like a little bit special and different. So I thought this might do the same thing, just to freshen up some of my Mulberry styles, and I think it's absolutely beautiful. And the colorway is very just neutral and lovely and classic. So you have some taupes and creams, this kind of gray color that has like a hint of purple, and then like a very dark, almost black shade as well. You have the Mulberry logo right there, and I just think this is gorgeous. So I'm very excited to dress up my Mulberry bags. Mulberry is included in the discount code as well. So if you did have your eye on something from Mulberry, often they do have end of season sales, but I always find that the really popular styles aren't included. So if you did want a Mulberry redesign Lily, or if you did want a mini Alexa, then it's a great way to save a little bit on those styles. And I am just super, super excited about this. And then last but not least, I did get a little something from Chanel as well. This is continuing on my pre-loved finds from Chanel, but I've been on the lookout. In fact, I'm gonna show it to you first and then I'm gonna explain what I was on the lookout for. But I saw this and thought it was absolutely perfect, and I am very, very excited about it. So I've already torn into the packaging, but it did come beautifully packaged with all the original packaging, which I was super happy about. So you do get the ribbon, you have the little camellia as well. And then I did get the original receipt, which is always great. And then you do have the Chanel dust bag, and inside is the O case in the white grained leather. So you do have silver hardware with this one. You have the little Chanel logo right there. The grain leather is the kind of classic caviar leather, but it's actually quite soft and malleable, which is nice because sometimes it can be very, very stiff indeed. And then you do have one pocket right there on the back. You have the classic Chanel quilt all over, and then it opens up with a very, very smooth zip. You have the little Chanel logo right there at the end of the zip as well. And if you're familiar with the O case, then you'll know it's just a very simple interior. So you have a white fabric interior. I also got all the care card details with it as well. And then on the back there, you do have one zip pocket, which is actually quite deep as well, which is nice. Just zips closed like so. And it's a really, really nice pouch. It's not super deep at all, but it is quite tall. And I basically wanted something which would kind of not replace, kind of help assist my Chanel white classic flap. That's in the medium size and I wear that all the time. But after my color transfer incident that happened a couple of summers ago, I have been a lot more careful wearing it. I did get the Chanel Melody to kind of use it as still a very luxurious Chanel option, but that was a little bit cheaper than the classic flap. But I didn't really get on with that bag, as I've documented in a few videos. So I've been looking for something that I can take on holiday with me. I don't think I would really take a Chanel classic flap at this point, just because they are so expensive and I just don't know if something's gonna happen to them. So I wanted something which really had that Chanel look that I love in a nice fresh colorway like white, but which wasn't going to cost just a ridiculous amount of money to replace if something happened to it. And I saw this and I thought it completely fit the bill. I do know I like this kind of style already because I do have a Saint Laurent wristlet in a similar kind of size and shape. It is a bit smaller than this, but I thought this was kind of perfect for what I need. It wasn't like super, super cheap, but I did get it pre-loved, so it was definitely cheaper than getting it from the store, and I think it's going to be exactly what I need. So I am super excited about it. I was on the lookout for something that could help kind of replace my Chanel classic flap when I didn't want to use something that expensive. Didn't know exactly what I wanted to get, but then this popped up and I was like, oh yes, like that's exactly what I want. I'm absolutely thrilled, and I never actually looked at this style before in the boutiques. You know, I've always kind of bypassed them, but I feel like this was exactly what I needed and wanted, and I'm just super excited about it. And it's in great condition as well, it looks pretty much new, so very excited about this. I am going to be using this on holiday in Greece, so I will let you know how I get along with it. But yeah, absolutely thrilled with my find. So that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. As usual, I will include links to everything I featured in the description section below. I will also include all the details for that discount code if you did want to check that out as well. If you have any questions for me, then leave me a comment, and please do give this video a thumbs up if you like luxury unboxing videos. As always, thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys. I don't know how or how you do it. You blow my mind without a word. Ooh, stuck upside down. I might be dreaming.